Hi children, good morning all. So we can complete the remaining part of our chapter. That's only a little is remaining in the chapter environment. The first part is about what happens when we accumulate waste in the environment. So the waste disposal, it is considered as one of the serious factor. In our daily life, we generate a lot of materials and throwing them away. These waste materials which will accumulate in the environment for shorter or longer durations. So, this waste is mainly classified into two types or two categories of waste other. We studied about this kind of waste in lower classes. What are they? They are the biodegradable waste and non-biodegradable waste. What is this biodegradable waste? Which include the substances such as household garbage, human waste, plant waste, agriculture waste, paper, cloth, etc. The microorganisms which can act on this biodegradable waste and degrade them or decompose them into simple organic matter and which will mix with the soil. That is why they are known as a biodegradable. That means the microorganisms are able to act over this kind of waste. Generally, the dumping of biodegradable waste is not considered as a serious matter because it will automatically or naturally get decomposed. But if it is accumulating in large amounts or large quantities, it may cause some of the harmful effects, such as decomposition of biodegradable waste result in the production of foul smell, which spreads the surrounding areas and makes them so miserable. And another matter, the flies, such as mosquitoes and other kind of house flies, they may breed at huge heaps of solid waste, and which acts as this site of or the breeding place for the mosquitoes and others, and makes them, which can carry the germs of diseases and causes a number of diseases such as diarrhea, typhoid, cholera, etc. And also, this biodegradable waste may block the drains, and some of the dumping of this biodegradable, especially the industrial degradable biodegradable waste, reduces the fertility of soil. So these are some of the harmful effects of biodegradable waste. The second category is the non-biodegradable waste. What are these non-biodegradable waste? Just opposite of the biodegradable. That means they cannot be degraded by natural means. That is, it not by the microorganisms. They are not able to act, not able to decompose this kind of unknown biodegradable waste. Only the high temperature and pressure only can degrade or convert them into harmless ones. And also, when we are keeping or throwing away into the surrounding area, it will be there for a long time and make various kinds of pollutions, both soil pollution, water pollution, air pollution, etc. So what are the harmful effects of this non-biodegradable waste? Excessive use of all this kind of fertilizers, pesticides and other kind of industrial chemical waste affect the soil fertility, and also subsequently it may reduce the crop yield. And this kind of non-biodegradable waste result in another phenomena, that exists in ecosystem called biomagnification or biological magnification. It is nothing, that is the accumulation of this non-biodegradable waste in the successive trophic levels of a food chain. And finally it may enter into the body of human beings. This is what is called biomagnification. Then what are the different methods of disposal of this biodegradable waste that we studied in the lower classes? Landfills, filling of the lands, recycling of waste, preparation of compost. Compost is usually prepared by using biodegradable. Non-biodegradable waste is not using for that. And another one is the production of biogas and manure that we can do. Then another one is the incineration or burning at high temperature. Incineration means, in nowadays we can see in all the hospitals, schools and other public areas, we can see the incinerators. Incinerators are the special device used to dispose or burn the non-biodegradable waste. Burning at a high temperature, more than 1000 degrees Celsius, it is taking. So what will result? All the non-biodegradable waste which will becomes burned and also leaving a little ash only, not producing any harmful gases. Only carbon dioxide and water vapor is producing. There is no production of harmful gases. At last it is given about the ozone. In the chapter you can see about a little part regarding ozone. Ozone, is it familiar to you? That we studied in the chapter, this management of natural resources from 9th standard. Ozone is one of the isotope of oxygen, or a form of oxygen which contain 3 oxygen atoms. It is usually found, generally found in the stratosphere, that is above the troposphere. We can see this ozone. Do you know how this ozone is forming there? Ozone is formed by the action of UV radiations over oxygen molecule. Because of the action of UV radiations, the oxygen molecule gets degenerates or dissociates into 2 oxygen atoms. These free oxygen atoms are highly reactive. They may combine with the oxygen molecules and forms ozone, O3. So because of this chemical reaction, we can see there is a continuous blanket, a layer of ozone in the stratosphere. This is called ozone blanket. As we know, the ozone layer in the stratosphere acts as a shield to protect all type of this harmful effects of UV radiations from the sun. Because of the industrialization and also the increased pollution level, what is happening, you know, now the thinning of ozone layer is happening now. The thinning of ozone layer is commonly called ozone depletion. The air pollutants, mainly the chlorofluorocarbons, CFCs, are the main this factors responsible for the depletion of ozone layer. Besides this, methane and oxides of nitrogen also cause destruction of ozone. CFCs are synthetic harmful chemicals which are widely used in refrigerators, air conditioners, as coolants, in fire extinguishers, and also propellants. Once these CFCs are released in the air, these harmful chemicals produce active chlorine, that is a free chlorine atom. By the action of UV radiations, this CFCs has the capacity to produce free chlorine atoms. This free chlorine atoms can break the bond of this O3 and convert them into oxygen molecule. Due to this, the thinning of ozone in the atmosphere is happening. What are the harmful effects of this ozone depletion? The thinning of ozone layer allows more ultraviolet radiations to pass through it and they may strike over the air. This causes a number of harmful effects for animals and also human beings and plants too, which include skin cancer for human beings and also damage to eyes such as cataract and other kind of this eye disorders. And it may destroy the protective immune system of our body. That means it may lower the resistant capacity of our body. It will also adversely affects the plant life, that is a retardation in the plant growth and also deterioration in the quality of the natural resources, the complete destruction of the aquatic plants and animals. All these are the side effects of this ozone depletion. Nowadays, the UNEP, United Nations Environment Program, produce an agreement between the nations to reduce the use of CFCs. Instead of this, alternatives of CFCs can use. So you have to read the textbook, and that's all about the chapter. Our environment, it is very simple. You have to find out more and more multiple choice questions, one word questions, name the following, etc. from this chapter to get an idea about this chapter. Okay, that's all. Thank you.